Welcome everybody. Again, I wanted this get rid of this confusion, this misunderstanding of these two particular commands. Alright, the default information originate versus the no auto hyphen summary. Now, it is simple. The default information originate is exactly what it says there. You're just advertising a default route. So the router that gets connected to the ISP, you create a default route to the ISP. Default route. Is it default static route? Yes. Do not get them confused. They're two separate things. I'll do another explanation on that some other time. Default static route. All right, you point it to the ISP. And then what you do is in the router RIP configuration for version 2, because RIP version 1 nobody uses. If you still are, wake up, get rid of it, nobody uses it. Okay? RIP version 2. Alright, or RIPNG if you're using IPv6. So within RIP version 2, you type default hyphen information originate. Okay? And that way you will then inject the other routers with an R and an asterisk that will allow you, or allow them, those routers, to know where, hey, where's the internet? Where's it at? Oh, there it is. It's in my routing table. Let me go that way. That's all it is. And also keep in mind, you're taking this test for the CCNA, for the 200-125. Will it be in the new one? I don't know yet, okay? But is this in the new, is this in this one? Maybe, they may ask you a question on it, I don't know. But there's been a lot of questions on the confusion. No auto summary, all it does, it says, hey listen, your distance vector routing protocol, you summarize the networks to the classful boundary, as you may see there, x.000 for an A, XX.0.0 for B, XXX.0 for a C. We don't want that because we subnetted those addresses and our entire network is subnetted with a class A address. The routing protocol, now the distance vector routing protocol, will summarize the network. So where's it gonna go? You have all this redundancy in your network, you wanna do all this stuff, but then it says, you want me to go to the 10 network, but my network is all 10. It's all 172.16 or 192.168.100, whatever. Okay? But it's everything is submitted either with a class A with a 24, class B with a 24, class C with a 28. I don't know. But it summarizes by default. So you need to disable that summarization. That is why we do no auto hyphen summary, not only on RIP, ladies and gentlemen, but we also do it on EIGRP for the CCNA certification. I'm not trying to be a jerk, okay? But I just want to make sure that everybody gets this and the rumors through the grapevine stop. The way that I show you how to configure RIP, how to configure EIGRP for the CCNA is how it needs to be done. But I'm gonna leave you with this very extremely simple lab, which you can replicate either on the packet tracer, or if you have Genesis 3, use Genesis 3. If you have real world equipment, wherever you want to, okay? Replicate it, it's a video. Pause it, stop it, whatever you need to do. Replay it a million times so you can get it done. Alright? So that is the difference between these two commands. I just had questions, you know, people are still being getting confused, and that's why, even though it's part of one of my episodes, I believe it's in episode 3, the latest one I did, episode 4 is on its way, okay? I had to pull this out and had to do something specific on it because there were a lot of questions on it and somebody's spreading rumors, and I don't like rumors. Two different commands, two different purposes, All right. This is for your certification. You can use this in the real world. You can use this in the real world as well. Okay. But for your certification, if you do not configure the running protocol like I show you, like I do my boot camps, which by the way, one is coming up in August 1st, today, all right, at 7 o'clock tonight Eastern time, okay? But the way I show you how to configure is to make sure that you get your certification, your CCNA 20-125, before the February 24th, 2020 deadline, okay? Because then you have a lot more things to worry about than default information originate on the auto summary. Okay? So again with this, thank you for listening. Look at the lab, pay attention to the lab. Alright? That's the way you do it. And also remember, this is not an ISP. So we are pretending that we're going to a public side. The public side is not advertising any network into the private network. Okay? It's not even a real ISP, it's a pretend ISP. Okay? It's a simulator or an emulator, like Jimmy said. I'll leave you in the lab. All right, so here we are in a very simple lab. Very, very simple lab. We have, this is GNS3, desktop version, no major thing here. All right, here we have router 1, router 2, router 3, and our pretend ISP, okay? So if we take a look at each one of the routers, router 1, let's take a look at the IP addressing, show IP in brief. You see that we have the 10.115, and it is up, and what I'm gonna do this so everybody can see, and I'll actually do this up a little bit there, okay? So we can go ahead and see all the routers and what we're doing. So that's router 1, all right? It is up. That's the first interface. Then we go to router 2. Let's do the same exact thing. Alright. Alright, I'm gonna do show IP in brief. Oops. That's coming. Alright, and you can see it's up 10.19.6. This is the networks that we're using. But I just want to show you that the routers are up. Alright. And then at least the main routers. This is router 3. Okay. I'm gonna come here, we'll look at router 3, we'll bring him over here, bring it over here, do show IP in brief. That is router 3. Router 3 is connected to the internal network, and you see it has a connection to the external using a fake public IP, but it's within the range, right, of public IPs, all right, and it's assigned to that F110, and then the ISP, of course. Well, you can see it right there, but again, we want to make it the same as the rest of them. We'll put this guy over here and go over here. And you can see that. Do show IP in brief. And everything is up. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to configure RIP, right? Like we normally would, right? So, this is how you configure RIP, ladies and gentlemen. Router, oh, we gotta be in global configuration first. Config T, router RIP, version 2, no more version 1. Alright, net, short for network, 10, and I'm gonna prove a point here, 10.1.1.4, okay, enter, then no auto hyphen summary. That tells it, told you in the presentation. That please do not summarize it when you send it out on the updates, send the mask along with it. And it also allows for this contiguous network. I'm gonna do WR here, but I'm also gonna do a do show start just to show you something. Okay, and I'm gonna go, hit more. I'm hitting more, or I'm hitting enter, not more. Okay. It summarized it. Okay? It will do that. So we gotta make sure that when it sends it out in the updates, it doesn't summarize it. So we disable summarization by using no auto hyphen summary. Same thing for EHRP. What you do in the real world, it's not gonna happen in the CCNA. You configure EIGRP with wildcard mask, you're gonna fail. Alright, that's router 1. I'm gonna go to router 2. Alright, so we're in router 2. Go router with Vertu. So if that's the case, even though I'm connected to two separate networks, I'm gonna say net 10000. No, I don't have any zone. Do WR. What's the big deal? All right. Then I'm gonna go to router 3. All right. Router RIP version 2 network 10000, and then we do have this network that we're attached to. Oh, okay. Well, if we do that, you know what? Let's not advertise that. Let's not advertise that. We're gonna do no auto summary. DWR. So let's open this up a little bit more, okay? And then what we're gonna do, let's minimize these other routers so we don't get confused. There's no confusion on anything. All right, so I'm gonna open up router 3, do a control Z, okay? I'm gonna do a show IP route. Show IP route, we see we're getting a 4, right? You see down here, we're learning from RIP about the 10.114 network, okay? 120, you know, and then we're learning it from our neighbor, all right, on our F10 interface. All right, cool. So let's see if we can ping 10.1.1.9. Awesome. But we want our routers to be able to go out to the internet. Can we ping that 1.1.2? Ping that 1.1.2? Yeah, we can because we're connected to it, but the other routers can't. They have no freaking idea, right? So, if we look at their routing table, let's take a look at the router. Let's look at router 1. Let's look at router 1's routing table, right? Control C. Let's do Control Z. Okay, let's see. Show IP route. It knows about the 8, so I can ping 10.1.1.9. But there's no way I'm going to be able to ping 101.101. I don't know about that network. Can we do defaults all the way across? Can we do statics all the way across? Sure, right? Small, minor companies can do that, but we're not gonna do that, okay? What we're gonna do in router 3, and be careful with the GNS3, you have to make sure you go back, don't reopen the same router twice, okay? What we're gonna do is, we're gonna say, okay, config T, we're going to create a default route, IP route 0.0.0.0, 0.0.0.0, and then here it gives me a choice. Do you want to put an IP address? Do you want to put an interface? What is it you want to put? I'm going to put the next router's hub address. How about that? 1.1.1.2. Okay, I'm going to use that. Okay. And then I'm going to go router RIP. So I created a default route using the neighbor's hub address, which is by ISP. And I'm going to do router RIP version 2. I always type version 2. All right. And then I'm going to do, let's question mark it so we can see it. Here it is. The infamous default information. Originate. So I'm going to click that, right click that. Ooh, real ILS, default information. What can we do here? Default information. How about originate? Okay, so it doesn't matter. Oh, because I missed one letter. Okay, default hyphen information. And then we do a question mark. And that's all we can do, originate. And then, yeah, we're going to do a route map. We're not doing route maps, CCNA. Or we're going to just enter at that point. Cool. Do WR. Control Z. Arrow, or just enter a bunch of times. I'm gonna do a show IP route. I still only see a static route, right? Or a default static route, because you got that asterisk. It's not the same thing as a regular static route, okay? And you can see it up here. The gateway of last resort is set to 1.1.1.2, okay? Okay, so let's take a look at router 1 now. Oh, wrong. Wait, all right, one. Okay, so let's bring this up here. Let's bring on the routing table. Get rid of all this junk. Show IP route. Hey, look, we got something new here. R1, or R asterisk, I'm sorry, R asterisk. And it's going out this way to 10.16. Okay? And let's see what it's doing. Can I still ping all the way across? I should be able to, right? I don't know about that network. 10.1.1.10. I still can ping there. Can I ping now the other side? Ping 1.1.1.1. Lo and behold, I can. Can I ping all the way? I can ping all the way across. That is what default originate command does. That is its purpose. That you didn't see me do anything on the ISP, did you? Not a thing. I didn't do rip on the other route. Oh, he's tricking us. He's doing, I got rip configured here. Yeah, for sure. Show IP protocols, right? That's the command. Learn that command. It's good. It's very useful, right? I am running rip on here, but on my ISP, am I running a protocol? Let's open it up. Show IP protocols. Oops. Show IP protocols. I'm not running any routing protocols on there. And in router 3, I did not advertise through RIP. Well, I did a default route, but not the actual network. If you look at it, I'm only routing for this network. So that is the difference between default information originate, which advertises a default route, and no auto summary. So please do not summarize the networks out of the updates. Two separate commands, two different definitions, not the same thing. I hope this was useful. I'll see you guys in episode 4.